Hello, so today with us we have the Dean of Student Welfare, Professor Barua, and Associate Dean of Student Welfare for Bhavan MS, Professor Upadhyay. Thank you so much for consulting for this interview and having me here.
Thank you.
Okay, sir, we are glad to have you here. So I would like to start with the interview with our first question, that are there plans to call back other batches of students for the spring semester?
Yeah, there are plans, and before letting you know the plans, let me tell you, so far we have allowed around 650 PhD scholars, around 150 M.Tech final year students, around 20 B.Tech final year students, and those scholars who are residents of Uttarakhand state, especially Haridwar district. So around 30 to 40 students have been allowed, and they are coming to the department as a desk scholar. So they come to the departments every day morning and go back in the evening. So on, if you look at all these figures, we have allowed around 850 students last 2 months time.
Yes, okay, so that's a large number. So, sir, right now you can't discuss the plans about other students.
Yeah, so as I told you that we allow students on the, after looking at the prevailing situation. So we have got constraints of accommodation, especially the accommodation which we require for quarantining. So we don't send students to Bhavans directly. We first quarantine a student for 10 days and then he goes to the Bhavan.
Okay.
So sir, on this point only, so given that this final year batch for the undergraduates will be traveling back around this time, so what all protocols will be followed when they arrive on the campus?
So SOPs are there in place. It's not especially for B.Tech final year students. So SOP is there for all the students. So first of all, whenever we allow a student, we ask him to register at Uttarakhand government's portal. Then we ask the candidate to bring negative COVID report of the four tests which are available. For example, TrueNet, CBNet, Rabbit antigen test and RT-PCR test. So the candidate has to bring one of the negative reports. After that, we quarantine the candidate in our guest house, and then we send him to the Bhavan. So this is the SOP which we have been following for PhD, for M.Tech, and for B.Tech students also. We would be following the same thing.
Okay, very fine, sir. So, sir, and I would also like to ask that, what additional rules will be imposed to maintain safety in mess, hostels, classrooms? Will canteens will be opened?
Yeah, in fact, as we are getting more and more students in our campus, whenever we see that there is a crowding taking place in any mess, then we open another mess. So we ensure that no crowd, gather at one particular mess. So this is the additional thing which we are doing. So the moment we get a new set of students, we create additional mess. So this is one thing. And the other thing which we are doing is we are ensuring that the wing level occupancy does not exceed 50%. So it's not only the hostel level occupancy we are seeing. We are very proactive in ensuring safety and security of our students.
Okay. And as a small follow-up to this, so would canteens or visiting restaurants outside or stuff like that be available?
Professor Upadhyay would be able to answer this question in a better manner.
So we have already started the canteens. One canteen's already started in Azad Bhavan. Then another is in Kotle Bhavan. We have all. And we are not allowing any seating arrangement, take away only, and some limited food items we have provided by considering the COVID-19 guidelines. And also, when just in 1st December, we opened the canteen as per the requirement of the students. And the, when canteen opens, so canteen owners and their workers, they will come on the campus with negative RT-PCR report. And presently, we are not allowing any canteen worker to outside campus. So we have temporary allowing campus. We have provided their accommodation temporary for safety point of view of students. So on presently Azad Bhavan, then Kotle and Kasturba, we have started the canteens.
And one more thing, in fact, usual timings of the canteens were from 2 p.m. to 2 a.m., but we are operating only from 4 p.m. to 12 midnight.
Well, yeah, up to 12 we have allowed.
Okay. So since the institute hospital would be the first point of contact in case anything happens, so what facilities would be available there, or what is the capacity, all of those things?
In fact, the right person to answer this question is CMO, but let me tell you, our hospital is helping us a lot. The first point of contact for a student is our hospital only. Students report to hospital first, and from hospitals they go to guest house, and then from guest house to home. And whenever we see any symptoms in a candidate, then our hospital usually takes those students to the CMS for testing purposes and bring back in our institute's ambulance. So our hospital is quite prepared and proactive.
Okay, sir. So, sir, in the follow-up, if you can also answer that, what is the testing capacity our institute can offer daily, on daily basis, or maybe?
In fact, let me tell you, our institute doesn't test for COVID.
Sure.
We are not ICMR approved testing facility. So the testing is done at the civil hospital, Roorkee.
Okay, sir. Okay. That would answer that.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. So I would like to ask you the next question, that how many students are on campus right now? Okay, so you answered that part. But and how is the institute ensuring their well-being? Like, is there periodic testing taking place for them?
In fact, as I told you, there are SOPs in place for bhavans, for messes, for other facilities like sports facilities. There are SOPs available for, let's say, cultural council, for MSS, for NCC, for HECs. So we ensure that students follow these guidelines, especially three important points I would like to mention. We ensure that physical distancing is maintained, the first very important point. The second is hand hygiene practices are followed. And the third one is wearing of mask. So we ensure that these three things are followed strictly. Be the student is in Bhavan or mess or in department or anywhere else in the campus.
Okay. So in the follow-up, what are the guidelines for letting a student going outside the campus? Are they allowed to go outside the campus?
Since there is no lockdown in the city, so students are going outside, though we want them to go outside whenever there is a need for it. Otherwise, they are advised to stay in Bhavan itself, to stay in department itself. And they should wear masks whenever they are out of their room.
Okay.
In fact, our safety officer has circulated several emails to our students that whenever a student is out of the Bhavan room, he or she should have mask.
Okay. So recently in last month, IIT Madras also had invited a few of their students to come back, but we saw that they had a large COVID outbreak there. So let's hope that our like protocols do ensure that this doesn't happen, but in case something like this does happen, how would we be prepared to deal with it?
In fact, the point is, you would have seen the report that the major outbreak happened there on different addas. They call it canteens, right? Different canteens. So we are ensuring that crowding is not, taking place at different canteens. So this is the first thing which we have done, and we have just kept take our facility from canteens. And at a time, not more than 20 students can avail the facility at all those canteens which are opened. And we are prepared and we are proactive. I don't think such a situation would occur over here.
Okay, thank you, sir. I think that answers all our questions at this point.
Here, just I want to say something regarding, as already Dean of Student Welfare, Professor Barua, already told you. So, safety point of view, we are taking care of mess and bubble levels also, because since lockdown, we have not evacuated the hostels. At that time, during lockdown, there are 2,000 students in our campus, and we take care of all of them. And presently, we are 7 messes are running smoothly, and all messes maximum 150 capacities we are allowing students, as we are saying about the IIT Chennai case. So 7 messes are running, and at a time on a single mess, 150 students are allowing. Means only 150 allowed. At a time, only 50 sitting arrangement we have done. And all mess workers are residing on campus since March. So very less chance to infection of the COVID, because if they are going outside, then it will be maybe some possibility. But since March, they are staying on campus. We are providing temporary accommodation. And recently, after Professor Barua joined Dean of Student Welfare, we have Bhavan and mess around 350 workers we have done RT-PCR test for safety precautions. So we are taking care of all of this.
Okay, so that's great. It sounds quite safe, and we hope that other students can also come soon. So we hope that. Thank you so much, sir, for your
just one message to all the students. I request all the students who are on campus to strictly follow SOPs, maintain physical distancing, always wear mask, and always practice hand hygiene practices. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.